Adobe's just released an update to Photoshop, Photoshop 2022. Right now, I'm going to show you my top new features inside of Photoshop. The first one is this amazing object selection. What we do is we go down and grab the object selection tool. Now, when we've selected this, it's going to use Object Finder. So you'll see this little wheel spinning, and what it's doing is it's looking for objects. As we roll over, it shows us the selectable objects. So I can click and it's gonna load a selection on there. If I hold down the shift key and I click again, it's going to load the second one. Now you can go up into select and mask, refine that selection, but I'm just gonna use it for now just quickly to show you another feature that I love. So I'm gonna combine this with another photo. So just drag this in and then I'm gonna release it here. But Control T or Command T will enable me to go into free transform. And so we go to mask these together. For this tutorial, I just want to highlight the features. I'm not taking the time to refine the edges. Check out my other tutorials where I've created a separate tutorial more in depth in each one of these features. All right, so what we want to do is match the foreground with the background color. So we're going to choose filter. And under the neural filters, there's several new neural filters. And one of those is harmonization. If we turn this on, it enables us to select the background. And this will automatically update this. Now, once again, I've got more detailed tutorials where I go in and I refine it and make it match better, but I just want to show you how those work. Next one here is we have the ability to do color transfer. That means we can take the color from one image and apply it to another. So say, for example, I want to make this more kind of grab the color maybe from there. Notice we can really intensify that color. And of course, you can also grab custom images, and I'll show you guys how to do that in a separate tutorial, so check that out. All right, let's look at another neural filter, which is really amazing. If we choose the filter and we go down to neural filters, let's do the landscape mixer. We'll turn this on, and now we can grab literally the environment from another photograph and apply it to this photo. You can see how amazing that is, and we're just gonna click OK. So with these crazy features, how do we know when a photo is real anymore and when it's not? And I'll show you exactly how. If we choose window, we now have the ability to do content credentials. Now this is in beta, so it's not like fully functional or anything yet, but literally we're looking at this image and hit preview. All right, and so this is telling me this is the photo that we're working on here, and you can load in any photo and it'll tell you, hey, there's been some edits in here. We've got imported assets, we've got AI tools are being used, combined assets, see, and paint tools, so we can see different things have been used in here. And as you can see, and previously I did a sky replacement, and we can see the different images and everything that have been used there. So this will actually travel with the image. So that means you can take an image and you can find out if that image is being edited or not. All right, other filters, they've been busy with the GPU. One of them is the rulers here, Control R. These rulers are now GPU powered, which just makes them a little bit more, a little quicker. You know, if we zoom in, see they're more responsive. Awesome. Another feature a lot of people are gonna be excited about. Under the filters, under stylize, you got it. Oil paint is back. But this time it's much quicker because this is GPU powered. So if we turn on the preview, we can see it works pretty quickly. And there we go. You can apply your oil paint effects. If any of you ever use Illustrator to create logos and different things, check this out. Here's a fake logo that I created. I'm just gonna make a selection around it. Hit Control C to copy. Let's paste it. Control V to paste. And notice we get all these options. Let's choose layers. Click OK. And boom, look at this. There's our logo. It's pasted, but the thing is that it's all in separate layers. And these are still vector paths here. And notice it's still in a vector. There's also improved pen support for Windows. So you guys that are using things like Wacom's on Windows are gonna be very happy. So this is just a quick video to show you my favorite new features inside of Photoshop. Now, I've made a bunch of other short videos where I go more in depth into each one of these. So check it out on PhotoshopCAFE.com or on the channel there at Photoshop Cafe here on YouTube. So anyway, guys, drop me a comment. Let me know, are you excited about these features? Which is your favorite new feature? Let us know. And also, if you're new here or you've been watching for a while, haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. And don't forget to check out my session at Adobe Max. I've got a lab on Photoshop for photographers where you're using some of these new features and also some other existing features. The labs are great because it comes with the work files, all the images I'm using, as well as I've created written instructions to go along with the video. So check it out. Max is going on this week and it's 100% free. I'll drop you guys a link underneath. So anyway, guys, do me one favor, please, and that's hit that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. So every video of mine you watch, just smash like. Thanks, guys. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.